I can hear you. Can you hear me? I can hear you, Rick. Can you hear me? Check 1, 2. Check, check, check. Check 1, 2. Rick, can you hear me? I'm right here, Rick. Okay, great. Okay. Oh. Okay. Well, that's good at least. Rick, have you seen the Indiana State Belmont score? It has about 2 minutes left in. It's got 2 minutes left in the game. It's 88-86. Okay. Did you say you needed a password for it? You could try the soy duds with 2 exclamation points and see if that'll work. Okay, great. Trying to think who might know that. Let me text Bob and ask. Okay, all right. Okay. We got plenty of time. Since it's just me, we're probably going to just do, about 10-minute pregame, so it's not a big deal. Okay.
Yeah, girl. I see Nash and I have the next home game.
Play ball.
Yep. Turn off the lights.
Welcome to John A. Logan Women's Basketball. It is a play-in game for the Lady Vols today. They play Lincoln Trail. These are the two bottom seeds in the crack this year as they get ready for the Region 24 tournament. And Logan is 2-0 against Lincoln Trail this year. 75-69 win on February 18th, 64-58 on January 14th, and we've just got a few minutes before the start of this one, so let's go ahead and get straight to our coach's interview with Coach Amanda Shelby right now.
Talking to Coach Amanda Shelby here on the pregame show before a game against Lincoln Trail. Coach, you look back at the season, and I think it's fair to say that a disappointment in terms of just how everything turned out. Is there anything that you look back on and wish you would have done differently to generate more than 8 wins this year?
Yeah, I mean, it is a disappointment because, you know, what we have, you know, the talent that we do have, it just, between all the injuries, between all the, a lot of stuff that's gone on, we never could get our footing down. So, you know, but the good thing about it, postseason's here, everybody starts 0-0. So, you know, maybe we can make a good run in the tournament.
And, you know, today's the play-in game. You play Lincoln Trail. You get the honor, whoever wins, to go ahead and go play Wabash on Sunday. And so that won't be an easy task for whomever comes out of this game. But the good news for you guys is you have it at home, and so you get the comfort of home. You get to, you don't have to sit on a bus for 2 hours going to Robinson. Just there's a lot of benefit in having this game here at Don Brewer Gymnasium.
Oh, big time. It's always more fun to play at home. You have your own fans, you sleep in your own bed. Like you said, you don't travel 3 hours in a bus and then get off and try to play. So that's a good, most important thing about it. And like we tell the girls, we get a win Friday, we go up there and play Wabash, and we just play however. We, you know, you never know. Anybody can be anybody on any given night. You know, they may have something go wrong the night before, or they may all be sick, or, you know, we may just hit every shot we throw up there, you know. So, I mean, anything could happen, and, you know, I tell the girls, let's go slay the dragon, so to speak, because, I mean, it is what it is. Let it all hang out and just play hard, but we got to get through tonight's game first.
You beat Trail both times you saw them this year. The one that really has stuck out the most to me is not Poe or Scroggins, but O'Handley really seems like if she gets into a rhythm, she controls the paint, makes it really difficult. She's a big girl, and so, you know, she can really control the paint down there if you let her go and get going. You can let her get her points, is how I feel, but if she can control the rhythm, then it really makes the game difficult.
Yeah, up there we let her get way too comfortable to be able to shoot from the outside, to drive the basket a couple times. So when we played him down here, she really wasn't that effective. But up there we did let her play way too well. So thankfully we're back here. Thankfully, you know, we've seen her at her best. So hopefully we'll be able to shut that down.
Poe is likely all freshman team member, I think. Scroggins is a very good player. But when you get past those two, they don't have a lot of scorers, and so I imagine you shut down one of them and it just will make everything else fall into place.
Yeah, Poe did make the all-region, all-conference, and she's a very good player. But yeah, you know, outside of those two and then the post player, there's not a lot, but that doesn't mean that they can't, I mean, they're college players, so anybody could be an All-American tonight. So we're trying to make sure we don't allow that to happen, just really shut down the two guards and, you know, just play our game, you know, pressing the whole entire time like we did up there against Lincoln Trail. That definitely did help, so we're going to be doing the same game plan we did up there.
And they're not the best at limiting turnovers. They're one of the worst in the nation, in fact, with over 20 a game. Your team likes to run, and so I imagine this is a good suited matchup in that way because, you know, they're going to go ahead and give the ball up a bunch, and so your team's going to get a lot of run-out opportunities.
Yeah, and that's how we came back and beat them up there at Lincoln Trail. You know, we got off the bus a little slow, of course, you know, after a three-hour drive, but, you know, third and fourth quarter, we really dug in and really, you know, our press really was highly effective then. We made some shots, and we just got up and down and wore them out.
Thanks a lot, Coach. Good luck.
Thank you.
That's the head coach of the Lady Vols, Amanda Shelby, about 30 seconds away from lineups and tip-off here. We'll keep things right here on the John A. Logan Women's Basketball Pregame Show on 103.5 ESPN.com. Matt Varney on the call solo today. This is the play-in game for the Region 24 tournament. Winner of this one gets top-seeded Wabash Valley, who is number 12 in the nation. So you win this one, and like Coach Amanda said on the pregame interview, you go and you try to slay the dragon. That's the big thing. But you got to get through each other in this play-in game first. Logan and Lincoln Trail about to go head-to-head. Both teams depleted from how things started. I was talking to Coach a little bit after that interview, and I was saying, you know, you look at how this team started. You expected to have Janiyah Thompson when you started recruiting for this year. And then through the course of the year, you lose four or five other players. And so this team for Logan completely depleted, whereas Lincoln Trail's down three players on what they have left on their roster as well. And so just both teams down to the bare bottom, seven for Logan as India Robinson is out with a sickness today, and Lincoln Trail has eight. Well, here's how Lincoln Trail brings out their first five. Sarah Mills, the first off the bench, a freshman forward, 5'9" out of Paris, Illinois. Alaysia Devine, a freshman forward, 5'11" out of Indianapolis. Gracie Poe on the all-region team, a freshman guard, 5'5" out of Bignell, Indiana.
You also have Chloe Sprinkle, a freshman guard, 5'6", out of Cloverdale, Indiana. And Jordan Scroggins is their sophomore guard, 5'6", out of Louisville. She averages 12.5 a game. Poe averages 15.8. So they're the two big scoring threats. And we mentioned O'Handley. She is one of the three that is out and not playing in this game. And so you immediately take away that big threat in the middle. For Logan, the first one off the bench is Cheyenne Trotter, a 6-foot freshman forward out of Springfield, Illinois. Lanphier High School is where she attended. On the season, she's averaging 8.5 points and 6.5 rebounds. Tally Woodford Bird gets her 11th start of the season. A 6-foot freshman forward out of Loire, North Carolina, went to New Madrid High School. Madison Kelvin, the 5'8 sophomore guard, a Ballard, Kentucky native, went to Ballard County High School. She's averaging 11 points and 6.3 rebounds. Shamira Brown, a 5'6 sophomore guard out of Forest City, Arkansas, is the point guard. And Olivia Hartman, a 5'7 sophomore guard out of New Madrid, Missouri, she averages 8.6 points and 5.5 rebounds for the Lady Vols. And there are your starting five for both sides. John A. Logan women's basketball, Lincoln Trail women's basketball, about to go head-to-head. Lincoln Trail Statesmen are led by Zach Law. He's in his second season as Lincoln Trail's coach. They're 3-24, went 1-13 in the GRAC this year. Logan, 8-17 this season, 4-10 in the GRAC. Coach Amanda Shelby, in her eighth season, they are 111-106 under Coach Shelby. Cheyenne Trotter sets up in the circle against Alaysia Devine. And the ball tipped up in the air. It's tipped. Madison Kelvin fights for it and gets it. And, oh, goes out of bounds. She just could not corral it in. I think she got a little lackadaisical there. And so it will be Lincoln Trail ball. A quick turnover 4 seconds into the game. Jordan Scroggins will bring it on up out of the backcourt with Shamira Brown showing a little bit of pressure. Get it on over to Poe. Now it's in the hands of Devine. Was looking back into Poe, or rather Poe, but Tally Woodford Bird takes it away. Kelvin down low with the left hand is good. She makes up for that turnover. 20 seconds in, Logan leads 2-0, and they are pressing hard. And here's a lob. Tally Woodford Bird with her second steal of the day. Gets it on over to Brown across the timeline, over to Liv Hartman. Gets it over to Trotter in the corner. Back over to Hartman, sets up for a deep two, and it bounces off. No good. Rebounded by Scroggins. Jordan Scroggins will bring it up herself across the half-court line. Gets it on over to Gracie Poe on the right wing. Sends up the three, and she launches it and makes it. 3-2 lead for Lincoln Trail. 9:05 to go in the first quarter here at Don Berg Gymnasium. It's the play-in game for the Region 24 tournament. Tyler Woodford Bird at the top of the key for Logan. Looks inside to Calvin, sends it up. She got fouled from behind by Devine and will send her to the line. That is a shooting foul. Calvin on the season, one of the better Vols at the stripe, 79.2%. Logan as a whole this season, 63.7. And so they've been struggling, but Calvin's pretty good. She's got all the points, makes the first one for Logan, ties it back up 3-3. A minute and 3 seconds into the game. Here's the second one, and it is good as well. She's got 4 points in the day. Logan's got 4 points. It's 4-3 against Lincoln Trail. Gracie Poe with it on the near side. Gets it across on over to Sprinkle. Now it's in the hands of Mills. On over to Scroggins. Into the hands of Devine. Sends up a deep two, and it goes off and rebounded by Calvin. Gets it on over to Hartman across the timeline. Steps on over to Brown on the right wing. Sends up the pull-up jumper. No good. Calvin gets the rebound. Swings it out to Woodford Bird for the left wing. Three. Oh, bounces off. No good. Rebounded by Chloe Sprinkle. Scroggins will bring it on up across the timeline and had to avoid Giant Trotter, who almost got a steal. Here's Sprinkle now on the right wing. On over to Scroggins on the right wing. Sends up the three, and it bounces off the back iron. No good. Liv Hartman almost had the rebound, but instead Poe gets the rebound. Sends up a jumper. It's good. So it's the Calvin and Poe show here today. 5-4, Lincoln Trail leads. 8:05 to go in the first quarter. Liv Hartman brings it across the timeline, working against Sprinkle and Scroggins. Scroggins almost stole it away, but Hartman was able to get it in the backcourt. Poked out, and Gracie Poe has it. Run out on over to Chloe Sprinkle. Sends up the right hand. It bounces off. No good. Poked out, and Scroggins chases it down, but Trotter gets it, but they say she stepped out of bounds, and it'll be Lincoln Trail ball. Gracie Poe will inbound on the far side sideline. 5-4 lead for Lincoln Trail. 7:49 to go in the first quarter. Poe bounces on over to Scroggins in the corner. Poked out by Brown. It will stay with Trail. Lady Statesmen, 3-24 on the season. So they're looking for win number 4 on the year. Just a very difficult season. They have a lot of freshmen on the team, though. Poe on the baseline, looking around, gets it underneath the cup to Scroggins and bounces back on out because she doesn't like her defense from Shamira Brown. And there's going to be a reach-in on Brown now. And that shouldn't be a shooting foul, and so they will be inbounding on the baseline once again. 7:41 to go in the first quarter. Poe on the baseline, looks around, Hartman's defending, and finally gets it into Mills at the last second. Gives it back over to Poe. She'll bring it around to the volleyball line. Gets it over to Scroggins. Right corner three, but Trotters blocked it and poked out, and Hartman has it now on the run out. Gets it over to Trotter, and she's going to have to slow it on up in the corner, and they're calling a double dribble on her. So it will be Poe inbounding on the far side sideline now. And now here's a three from Poe. She got fouled. No good on the shot, and so she will be going to the line to shoot three. Calvin picks up her first foul of the game, second team foul for Logan. Poe's going to go to the line to shoot three. She's got all the points right now for Trail. First one up and swishes it. She's got 6 points now today. Here's the second one, and it is also good. Looking to go 3 for 3, would have 8 points on the day. 7:18 to go. Here it is, and it is good. Gracie Poe with 8 points today makes it 8-4. Logan is trailing at home in the play-in game. And a skirmish on the other side, but Shamira Brown able to clean it on up. Reset at the volleyball line with Poe defending. Gets it into Wolford Bird at the top of the key. She's going to drive against Mills. Step back jumper and just over the head of the cup. And Liv Hartman sends it up and in. And she's going to go to the line as well to shoot the and one after a shooting foul that was committed by Scroggins. 6:56 to go in the first quarter. Logan trails 8-6. Here is the and one, and off the rim, no good. Rebounded by Sprinkle, and it is Trail ball once again. 2-point game, 8-6 with 7 minutes to go. Poked out by Trotter, but Devine able to bring it back in to Poe, and she steps in. Pull-up jumper, rattles around, no good. Mills gets the rebound, sends it up, no good. Rebounded by Brown and gets it on over to Hartman. She's going to swing on over to Calvin across the line, driving into the paint, flips it up with the left-hand hook. It's good! Calvin with 6 points. It's 8-8, 6:30 to go in the first quarter. Scroggins bringing it on up, gets it on into Sarah Mills across the timeline, back over to Scroggins, and she's racing on over to Poe, back over to Mills. Top of the key, three from her, and it's off the iron, no good. Rebounded by Calvin, and gets on over to Shamira Brown. Across the timeline, on over to Hartman in the corner, and she's defended by Poe. Steps to her left, backs on up, out to Trotter on the baseline, swings on over to Brown, top of the key, three, and she swishes it. Logan retakes the lead. It's 11-8 with 5:50 to go in the first quarter. Devine gets it on. Oh, stolen away by Trotter. Logan's pressure defense is affecting this game big time. She races down the court. She'll go to the stripe to shoot two after getting fouled by Devine. And that is Devine's second foul of the game. It is 3 team fouls for Trail. And in comes a couple players as Sprinkle and Mills and Devine take a seat. In comes Dasani Williamson and Amanye Allen and also A.J. Johnson. First one up and no good for Cheyenne Trotter. She has struggled at the line this season. Just 34.6% on the year, and that doesn't help it right there. Second one goes up, and she makes it. A rare sight right there for Cheyenne Trotter. It's a 12-8 lead for Logan, 5:40 to go in the first quarter. Logan was trailing by about forward just about a minute ago. Johnson, White sent it up after going in. No good. I think got blocked a little bit. Wolford Bird got the rebound. Got it on over to Brown. Over to Kelvin in the corner. Inside to Trotter. Lost it, but got it back out to Hartman on the left wing. Brown top of the key. And now she's looking. Going to go to the right. Reset. Bounce into Wolford Bird. Turn around. Job out the jumper, but found Cheyenne Trotter underneath the cup. Sent it up. Missed it, but going to the line after getting fouled by Williamson. The fourth team foul for Trail, and so one more, and Logan's in the bonus. Trotter with a point after going 1-for-2 just a moment ago at the line. First one up, and a little too strong. 5:13 to go in the first quarter. Logan leads it by 4, 12-8. This is the play-in game. Winner gets Wabash Valley on Sunday. Second one up, bounces off the rim, no good, and rebounded by Allen. And now Johnson's going to bring it on up for Trail. Over to Scroggins on the left wing. Shoots the three, and she flushes it. Wow. 12-11 is the score here at Logan. Here comes Calvin, and she had to beware. Almost got it stolen away. Wolford Bird with it in the corner. Over to Hartman, top of the key. Hartman on over to Brown on the left wing, brings it to the right, resets, 13 on the shot clock. Over to Hartman on the right wing, thought about the three, steps back, now over to Wolford Bird in the corner with a sagging defender, looked inside to Calvin and lost it, and Poe gets it. Here she comes, and she outraces everybody, sends it up, and it's good, and she'll go to the line as well after getting fouled by Trotter. And Logan's bringing their substitutions. Trotter picks up her first foul of the game, 13th foul for Logan. It is 13-12, Lincoln Trail leading, and Gracie Poe goes to the line when we come back in a minute on 103.5 ESPN.com.
Talking to Coach Amanda Shelby here on the
John A. is the only auto collision program in Southern Illinois. There's nobody else that offers it. We draw students from all over because there's just nobody else that offers the programs. The student-teacher relationship is one of the most important parts of this job.
You can't really go wrong here. Anything you want to learn, you can learn it here.
Whenever I started the program, I didn't feel too 110% about it. Like, I wasn't sure how I was going to do, but that's what makes me confident. It's the teacher and the students that I'm surrounded by.
Hi guys, TJ Cowan from Cold Blooded. Coming to you, wanted to introduce the Cold Blooded Single Barrel Smokehouse. Here at Johnny Logan College, you guys are used to our coffee. Now come check out our food. Not your average college, not your average food.
Time to go in the first quarter. Logan trails Lincoln Trail in this play-in game. 13-12. Gracie Poe going to the line to shoot an and one. She's got 10 of Trail's points. Jordan Scroggins got the other three. Madison Calvin, a big part of the offense here early on for Logan with 6 points. She's the only one with more than a bucket. But Gracie Poe has been fantastic early on, and she's right now looking like a quarterback out there directing how she wants to see Scroggins and the rest of the team direct things after this and one. Here's the attempt, up and good. She's got 11 so far, 14-12, 4:25 to go in the first quarter here at Logan. Winner gets Wabash Valley Sunday at 1 o'clock. Here is Brown, drives baseline, looks inside to Trotter, turn around, out to Kendra Johnson, who's coming to the game, steps to the right, drives in to the paint, lost it, got it back, and bumped into Dasani Williamson. She'll be going to the stripe here in a moment. Dasani Williamson came into the game to relieve Alicia Devine, and she's gotten 2 fouls, so has Devine, and so now I'm sure Coach Lal of Lincoln Trail is saying, what do I do? Johnson is a 77.8% shooter at the line. First one up and in. Earlier in the season, she was in the 80s. Sarah Mills coming back in for Trail. Second one up and good for Johnson, Kendra Johnson. And here comes Mills for Williamson. 4:08 to go in the game. Tie here at Logan, 14-14. Amonye gets it on over to Johnson, and they're going to call a travel here. She tried to pass and then decided, oh, you know what, I'm going to dribble it, but that's a travel right there. She'd already stopped. Kendra's going to inbound in front of Trail's bench. Gets it into Hartman in the corner inside the arc. Back out to Johnson, over to Brown top of the key. Gets a pick from Trotter, going with it to the left. Floats it on up from the free throw line. No good, and it goes out of bounds. It was airballed, and it'll be Trail ball. 3:55 to go in the first quarter here at Logan. It's 14-14 in this play-in game for the Region 24 tournament. Allen has it, passes to her left to A.J. Johnson across the timeline. Now it's in the hands of Poe. Left wing three on the fast break. Bounces off, no good. And Amonye Allen has it. Now over to Johnson, top of the key. Head fake, gets it over to Allen. And now back over to Scroggins. Top of the key, three. She lets it fly off the back iron, no good. Riley Johnson gets the rebound. On over to Shamira Brown. Across the timeline she goes. Sets up at the top of the key, goes to the right. Over to Kendra Johnson in the corner. Kendra's looking to get a pass off. Going to bring to the left now and gets it back on over to Brown top of the key to Hartman on the left wing. Into Trotter, send it up and in. That was a nice pass over to Riley Johnson, who quickly found a cutting Trotter and got the points right there. 3 points for Cheyenne. Here's Scroggins on the near side, drives in, gets it on over to Mills, poked out by Trotter, and they're going to say Mills touched it last, and it'll be Logan Ball. 16-14, Logan leads here. 3:04 to go. Chloe Sprinkles coming back on in for Amonye Allen. And here's Kendra Johnson on the baseline. Gets it on over to Shamira Brown. She'll bring it on up across the timeline. 3 minutes to go in the quarter. Riley Johnson was looking for Cheyenne Trotter underneath the cup, but couldn't find her. Liv Hartman saves it. On over to Trotter. Poked out. Goes out of bounds. It should stay with Logan. And it will, they signal. One of the Trail players touched it last. 2:49 to go in the first quarter. 16 on the shot clock. And Brown will inbound on the far sideline. Shamira gets it on into Trotter on the right wing. Inside to Riley Johnson. One bounce, send it up. Off the window, it's good. And so she's got a point. And now the only ball that hasn't scored in this quarter is Tylee Wolford-Bird. And poked out. It was a long pass that Riley Johnson poked out. Trotter stole it, and here now on the run, no good. It rolled out as Shamira Brown took it up and rolled out of the rim. Here's a jump ball as Trotter and Gracie Poe get tied on up, and it'll still be Trail ball. Gracie Poe wasn't happy with it, but you got to get physical when she's the one that's scoring all the points. 19-14 lead for Logan, 2:20 to go. Scroggins on the far side, goes across the timeline, gets it on over to Sprinkle on the right wing, on over to A.J. Johnson. Now Scroggins swings on over to Poe on the left wing. Poe back over to Sprinkle, top of the key. Gets it back over to Scroggins on the left wing, and she does a head fake, goes to the right, gets it over to Johnson, top of the key, drives inside. Here's a floater, no good, and Trotter had the rebound. Riley Johnson's the one that gets it, though. Brings it on over to Hartman. She's got Poe to beat. She's going to go inside, send it up with the right hand. It's good! Olivia Hartman. Hartman's got four. Calvin and Wolford Bird have checked back in for Logan. Minute 40 to go in the corner. Logan's leading 20-14. Here is Sprinkle in the corner, working against Riley. On over to Scroggins, over to Mills. Top of the key, three, and it's a little short. Kendra Johnson has the rebound. Kendra on over to Brown across the timeline. Brown steps in, gets it on out to Hartman. Over to Johnson, uncorked, sends it up, and just a little short. And it looked like it was just inside the arc as well. Scroggins brings it across the timeline after getting the rebound. Over to Poe, back over to Scroggins. Jordan Scroggins with the head fake. Now it's over to Sprinkle, over to Johnson, looking to step inside. Jabs gets it on over to Poe on the left wing again, driving in. Here's a pull-up, Jay, and it goes down for Poe. 20-16 with under a minute to go, 55 seconds on the clock. Poe's got 13 of the points for Trail. Here's Brown, left wing three, and it's short. Goes out of bounds, 45 seconds on the clock. And Wolford Bird and Calvin come on in for Trotter and Brown. Amonye Allen comes on in for A.J. Johnson. Poe will inbound on the baseline. Into Scroggins, back over to Poe. And she's looking around. Got to get moving. 5 seconds to go before the 10-second violation. Over to Scroggins. And now, just across in time, gets it on over to Poe. Curling inside. Stops, backing down. Back out to Mills for a jumper. It's good. Her first points of the game. And now 20 seconds to go. And Logan can have the last possession. Oh, there's going to be a block called here. Kendra Johnson was bringing it down, and she got blocked by Poe, her first of the game. 19.6 on the clock. And that is going to send Johnson to the stripe, as that's the 15th foul for Trail. Actually, the sixth. Johnson at the stripe. Looks up, sends it up, and good. Sandra Johnson has three, all at the stripe. Perfect at the stripe so far. Bounces again, looks up, sends it up, and bounces around, good. 4 points for Kendra Johnson here in the first quarter. 19 seconds to go, and it's the last possession if they want it. Oh, Riley Johnson steals it away out of the air. On over to Calvin, back on over to Liv. Oh, got poked out, and Scroggins takes it away. Nobody in front of her. Poe's there to help. Sends up the layup on the left hand. It's good. She's got five. And Calvin gets the inbound, but that's all we're going to be able to do here. 22-20. Logan leads it as we head to the second quarter here at Don Burr Gymnasium in Carnival. Logan leads Lincoln Trail in the playing game. We're back in a minute on 103.5 ESPN.com.
Welcome to Mac. How can I help you?
Hey, welcome to Mackey's Pizza. Every Monday night we have half-price cheese breadsticks. Monday through Friday we have a great lunch special. We can get 8-inch pizza, a small salad, and a drink for $7.49. So come out and see us and enjoy everything at Mackey's.
Our students are employed immediately. Sometimes they are employed before they get their associate's degree.
I have a position working in early childhood. Dr. Marilyn Tolliver, my professor, was able to really prepare me to be able to teach in a classroom as a lead teacher.
To see them interact and engage in what I'm teaching them is life-changing.
To 20 is the score here at John A. Logan College. The Lady Vols lead Lincoln Trail after the first quarter. It is Gracie Poe leading everybody with 13 points on Lincoln Trail. Logan is led by Madison Calvin with 6 points. Natalie Wolford Bird, the only Lady Vol without a point after that first quarter. Want to say thanks back to Rick Hayes in the studio, helping to bring this game to you. Could not do what we do without our board operators back in the studio. Logan's going to have the ball to start the second quarter and try to add on to this two-point lead. Calvin across the timeline. Logan's going to have to contend with what looks to be a 2-3 defense right now. Calvin on the left wing brings to the right and gets it on over to Hartman. Inside to Riley Johnson. Back out to Kendra Johnson. Sends up the three. Oh, just rolls off. Poked out by Wolford Bird, but they're going to call a foul on her. That was a push right there is what they say. And that's her first foul of the game, first team foul in the second quarter. 9:44 to go in the half. Jordan Scroggins gets the inbound, back over to Poe, back over to Scroggins. Across the timeline is where she's going to go. And set up on the right wing, send up the three, and bounces off no good. And Kendra Johnson gets the rebound. Kendra on the far side across the timeline with a pair trailing after her. Over to Riley Johnson, pull-up jumper. A little too strong. Liv Hartman gets the rebound, poked out, but sends it back up, and no good. Riley has the rebound, back up and in off the window. First points of the second quarter go to Riley Johnson. She's got four on the day. It's 24-20. Logan leading in the play-in game. On over to Sarah Mills at half court, back over to Scroggins. And she now settles at the volleyball line, goes to the right to the wing, flip on over to Sprinkle. There is a little bit of miscommunication, and they call a travel, I believe, on Scroggins, who it's going to be on. Sprinkle kind of ran into her rather than going around to receive the handoff. 8:57 to go till halftime, 24-20. Into Calvin it goes. She'll walk it up across the timeline with Liv Hartman behind her. Goes to the left, over to Hartman now. And she's going to get it on over to Johnson. Johnson back over to Hartman left wing. And inside to Johnson, which was Riley, and was looking for Wolford Bird. It's on the floor right now. Chloe Sprinkle takes it away. And now here's Scroggins across the timeline. Scroggins on the right wing, goes to the left, and gets it on over to Sprinkle. Sprinkle back over to Scroggins, top of the key. Gets a pick from Mills, goes with it to the right. Now it's over to Poe, gets another pick from Scroggins. Curls in, on over to Alaysia Devine. She's driving into the paint, stops, sends up a jumper, and no good. Wolford Bird has the rebound. Tyler looks around, gets it on over to Hartman. Liv inside to Riley, flip up with the left hand, it's good. Nice, quick, fast break score right there for Logan. 26-20 with 8 minutes to go till halftime. Riley Johnson almost took it out of the air again. And oh, Calvin decks a pass, steals it away, gets it over to Wolford Bird, and oh, looking for Riley on the other end, and it goes out of bounds. 7:53 to go, and Coach Amanda Shelby saying, that's okay, do it again. Just go back and do it again. Scroggins will inbound on the baseline. Shemira Brown, Cheyenne Trotter checking back in. Saw the hair, but I didn't correlate the height. Scroggins lobs on over to Poe on the other side, and she's going to drive in, pull up for a jumper, no good. Hartman has the rebound. Liv's going to bring it up across the timeline, blowing past defenders, runs into Devine, got poked out, goes out of bounds. Calvin tried to save it, but they're going to say instead it is, I believe, Logan Ball. Riley Johnson going to take a seat. She's got six on the day. Trotter comes in. Here comes Shemira Brown. And Liv's going to get her first break of the game. 7:35 to go. Brown will inbound on the baseline. And Antronesha Johnson, better known as AJ, comes in for Sprinkle. And Dasani Williamson comes on in for Alaysia Devine. Brown gets the ball, looking to inbound on the baseline, lobs into Wolford Bird, top of the key, back on over to Johnson in the corner, back out to Wolford Bird. Calvin, corner three, and it's a little short. Calvin almost got the rebound. Scroggins was the one that was going to initially have it. Poked out by Calvin, and it'll be Lincoln Trail ball. 7:27 to go in the first half. Johnson receives the inbound from Scroggins, and she's going to bring it on up out to Poe, and she's getting trapped. On over to Scroggins, across the timeline she goes. Now it's Johnson right wing over to Williamson on the baseline near the corner. Driving in now, lost it, picked it back up, turnaround jumper, it's no good. Wolford Bird gets the rebound. Here comes Kendra now across the timeline. Johnson gets it into Trotter, but actually it got poked out and Williamson took it away. Here's now Poe, and she sets up in the corner, looks around, sends up the three, says why not, and she makes it. Wow, 16 points for Poe. It is 26-23. That's the first points of the the quarter for Lincoln Trail. Took over 3 minutes. Calvin on over to Kendra Johnson. She'll bring it up. On over to Brown. Oh, Poe takes it away, and she's got clear court Calvin to beat. Sends it up. It's good, and Calvin's going to get hit with a foul on the block. Tried to set up for the charge. She's pleading her case, but at this point the whistle's already been blown, and Calvin picks up her second foul. Second team foul here in the second quarter. Calvin's going to take a seat on the bench. Liv Hartman's coming back on in. Calvin a little upset, you can tell by that call. Coach Matt Crane says, come on, take a seat next to me. And they're having a discussion about it now. Poe going for the and one here. She's 4-for-4 at the line, sends it up, and she's 5-for-5 now. She's got 18 of the 26 points for Lincoln Trail. It is 26-26. 6.5 to go in the half, and a travel called on Liv Hartman. She tried to get it to Tyler Wolford Bird, but took an extra step. 6:25 to go now in the half. Tied up 26-26 with Lincoln Trail in the play-in game. Winner gets Wabash Valley at 1:00 on Sunday at Lakeland College. Dasani Williamson across the timeline, driving in against Tyler Wolford Bird. She pokes it out of her hand, goes out of bounds. It'll stay with Trail. And Wolford Bird gives it over to the official, and looks like it'll be Poe inbounding right in the corner. Gracie Poe looks around. She is an all-region selection. Gets it on over to Johnson.
Johnson, top of the key, goes to the right, trying to work against Kendra Johnson to Scroggins, and Scroggins gets hit with a travel call. She turns around with an incredulous look. 6:09 to go. And Logan will try to break this tie, 26-26. Here comes Brown across the timeline, top of the key, goes to the right, over to Trotter in the corner, gets back over to Kendra Johnson, top of the key, back over to Trotter, top of the key, over to Wolford Bird, left wing, inside of Trotter, sends it up off the window, it's good. Nice play right there, just kept getting it back to Trotter until she cut inside, and Trail was surprised she was there in the paint. Johnson across the timeline, driving in, back over to Sarah Mills, sends it up, blocked by, I think it was Trotter, could have been Wolford Bird. They both went up and I think affected the shot. Logan takes it away over to Hartman on the right wings. Almost took the three. Down to Trotter. Back over to Hartman. Sends it up. It's good off the window.
Olivia Hartman.
6 points for Hartman. 5:25 to go in the half. And here now is Gracie Poe after Hartman almost stole it away. Send it up and in. She cannot miss. Only thing she's missing are threes, which are generally contested. Brown across the timeline. Gets it on over to Johnson, now over to Hartman right wing, sends up the three, nobody was there, but it airballs and goes out of bounds. 5:02 to go, Riley Johnson's coming in for Wolford Bird, Chloe Sprinkle's coming in for Sarah Mills. Coming up at halftime, we went through the archives to select a halftime show, and we said, oh yeah, Mike Murphy talked to Sean East earlier this year, and so if you weren't able to hear that, you'll hear it coming up at halftime, who was a star for the men's team last year. Double dribble called on Gracie Poe, turnover, 4:53 to go. So coming up at halftime, Shawnees, we're 4:53 away from halftime. Logan leads it here, 30-28. We are back in a minute on 103.5ESPN.com. Welcome back to John A. Logan Women's Basketball. Matt Varney on the call, flying solo this evening. Logan leads at 30-28 against Lincoln Trail in the play-in game for the Region 24 tournament. 4:53 to go in the second quarter. Shamira Brown has the inbound. Across the timeline she goes. Gets it on over to Liv Hartman on the left wing. Kendra Johnson, top of the key, steps in over to Trotter, stepping in. Back over to Riley Johnson, top of the key, over to Brown on the right wing. Now it's Johnson in the right corner, lobs it into Riley. Turnaround jumper off the window is good. She's got 8 points, leading Logan now with points. Scroggins on over to A.J. Johnson. Splits two defenders over to Poe, top of the key. Down low to Devine and gets it on over to Johnson. Working against Kendra Johnson now. Into the hands of Poe, goes to her left, over to Devine, and she couldn't corral it in, goes out of bounds. It'll be Logan Ball, 4:16 to go till halftime. Logan leads at 32-28, and Johnson has 8 points, and then you have Calvin with six, and also Hartman with six, and Cheyenne Trotter has five. So while Lincoln Trail's getting a lot of their points from Gracie Poe, Logan is spreading it around. Here's a three from Shamira Brown, just off the front iron, no good. Poe gets the rebound, and oh, tipped away, was looking for Johnson. Poe takes it from herself, though. Scroggins top of the key now, and now gets it on over to Sprinkle. She gets a pick from Scroggins, goes into the paint, gets it on up, sends up the three, or rather the two, no good for Devine, and Kendra Johnson has the rebound. Kendra avoids Chloe Sprinkle and gets it to the top of the key, over to Hartman on the far side. 3:40 to go, lob into Trotter, back out to Brown, top of the key, over to Liv on the right wing. Trail's been running the 2-3 defense and
pretty effective. Out to Trotter. Back over to Kendra, left wing three. And, oh, she nails it right there. Johnson with 7 points right now. The two Johnsons are leading the way for Logan. They have combined 15 points. Here's Poe on the far side. Gets it over to Scroggins. Top of the key, three, and she nails that. So she answers right back. And that's the first player not named Poe for Lincoln Trail to score in this quarter. 35-31, 3 minutes to go till halftime. Kendra Johnson down low to Riley Johnson, and they're going to say she got fouled by Devine. And she turned around to take a shot. I don't think they gave the continuation. She did make the shot, but again, I don't think they gave the continuation. Yeah, they're going to have her. They're going to have Brown set up on the baseline. Devine comes out, and Dasani Williamson once again comes in. Brown on the baseline, looks around, gets it into Hartman in the corner, and she'll bring it on in. On over to Johnson, top of the key, drives in. Oh, she got hit with a travel, and she got lucky. That's the turnover because Gracie Poe almost picked up a steal right there. 2:51 to go. Either way, it's a turnover. Poe gets the inbound, on over to Sprinkle. Logan's still showing that pressure defense in the backcourt. Over to Poe again. Four to go till the 10-second violation. Sprinkle brings it across, loses it though. Trotter takes it away. And Cheyenne's going to bring it across the timeline herself over to Shamira. Shamira inside to Riley. Turning around. And oh, stolen away by A.J. Johnson. Almost poked away by Brown. Over to Poe. She's got Hartman to beat. Stops it. And oh, they're calling the travel here. And Logan got lucky. Shamira Brown could have gotten hit with a push foul right there. But Poe instead gets called for the travel. And she extended her knee way out there trying to stop herself. 2:26 to go. Logan leads it 35-31 in the second quarter against Lincoln Trail. Winner of this one gets Wabash Valley on Sunday when the Region 24 tournament officially begins. Hartman on the left wing. Drives in and back out to Johnson. Uncorked in the corner for the three. Oh, Poe bounces off the rim. No good. Poe gets the rebound. 2:07 to go and a whistle. And I think Zach Wall's getting a warning, a sideline warning. And Cheyenne Trotter gets hit her second foul. But Zach Wall just got told by one of the officials, hey, you got to calm down. And they don't want to hear any more from him. 2:07 to go till halftime. Poe inbounds to Scroggins. Gets it on over to A.J. Johnson. Across the timeline she goes. Logan leads at 35-31 as we near halftime. Scroggins in the corner now, being defended by Brown. Gets it on over to Sarah Mills, top of the key, to Sprinkle. And now she's going to drive and get it back over to Poe, top of the key. Poe drives in, gets it on over to Scroggins, left wing, steps in, over to Johnson on the right wing. Johnson back over to Scroggins, top of the key. Shot fake, back over to Mills, right wing three, and no good, it was short. And now it's being fought for. Sprinkle gets it. And, oh, tipped out of the air. Shamira Brown has it now. And she'll bring it up with 90 seconds to go till halftime. At halftime, as I mentioned, Shawnee's was on Talking Vols Sports earlier this year and talked with Mike Murphy. We'll have that coming up at halftime. He's now at Mizzou, was the star for the men's basketball team last year. Minute 25 to go. Logan was looking to pass. Got poked out by Lincoln Trail into Wolford Bird on over to Brown on the right wing, over to Hartman, top of the key, and jab step goes to the left, over to Johnson. Riley gets it on over to Brown on the right wing, to Kendra in the corner, and was looking for Wolford Bird, got poked out though, and Gracie Poe is trotting down, gets it on over to Johnson, sends it up, and good on the right hand. A.J. Johnson picks up her first points of the game. Minute to go till halftime. Logan leads at 35-33. Here is Brown on the left wing, gets it on over to Kendra, top of the key. Bounce on over to Hartman on the far side. Hartman down low to Tylee Wolford Bird. She lost it, and Sprinkle took it away. Over to Scroggins it goes. Jordan Scroggins, top of the key, on over to Gracie Poe in the corner. She's looking around, brings to the right. Found a way into the alleyway, sends it up, no good. Riley Johnson gets the rebound. The run out to Liv Hartman. She's got Scroggins to beat, sends it up. Oh, she couldn't get it up, and goes out of bounds, stays with Logan. 31 seconds on the clock, 26 on the shot clock. 35-33, the lead for Logan here as we near halftime. Brown will inbound on the baseline. Shamira looks and finds Hartman in the corner. Back over to Johnson, left wing. Kendra back over to Hartman. 5 seconds separate game and shot clock. Brown, top of the key, sends up the three, and just a little short. A.J. Johnson gets the rebound with 17 on the clock. Over to Poe in the corner, sends up the three, and she flushes it down the toilet. Wow. She's been amazing here in this first half. 5 seconds to go until halftime. Brown over to Johnson. Kendra sends up the three, and just a little short. A.J. Johnson gets the rebound, and we are headed to halftime. Logan trails thanks to that three from Gracie Poe, 36-35. We'll step away for 2 minutes. When we come back, we'll look at the stats and then get you to that halftime interview with Sean East with Mike Murphy on Talking Vols. We're back in 2 minutes with halftime stats right here on 103.5 ESPN.
This is Lee Eklund. I'm the center director for Malone's Early Learning Center. You got to have that love and passion and being able to come here and see how rewarding it is to have a child learn how to tie their shoes or have a child learn how to stack blocks. It's so rewarding.
When I was at John A. Logan, it really gave me the mentality of we're coming in to teach the children, not to watch the children. And so it taught me the importance of engaging with them, becoming one with the classroom, and really having that involvement there.
Hey, welcome to Mathis. How can I help you?
Hey, welcome to Mackey's Pizza. Every Monday night we have half-price cheese breadsticks. Monday through Friday we have a great lunch special. We can get 8-inch pizza, a small salad, and a drink for $7.49. So come out and see us and enjoy everything at Mackey's.
John A. is the only auto collision program in Southern Illinois. There's nobody else that offers it. We draw students from all over because there's just nobody else that offers the programs. The student-teacher relationship is one of the most important parts of this job.
You can't really go wrong here. Anything you want to learn, you can learn it here.
Whenever I started the program, I didn't feel 110% about it. Like, I wasn't sure how I was going to do, but that's what makes me confident. It's the teacher and the students that I'm surrounded by.
Hi guys, TJ Cowan from Cold Blooded. Coming to you, wanted to introduce the Cold Blooded Single Barrel Smokehouse. Here at Johnny Logan College, you guys are used to our coffee, now come check out our food. Not your average college, not your average food.
Hey, welcome to Mackey's, how can I help you?
Hey, welcome to Mackey's Pizza. Every Monday night we have half-price cheese breadsticks. Monday through Friday we have a great lunch special. We can get 8-inch pizza, a small salad, and a drink for $7.49. So come out and see us and enjoy everything at Mackey's.
Our students are employed immediately. Sometimes they are employed before they get their associate's degree.
I have a position working in early childhood. Dr. Marilyn Tolliver, my professor, was able to really prepare me to be able to teach in a classroom as a lead teacher.
To see them interact and engage in what I'm teaching now is life-changing.
I'm the center director for Malone's Early Learning Center. You got to have that love and passion and being able to come here and see how rewarding it is to have a child learn how to tie their shoes or have a child learn how to stack blocks. It's so rewarding.
when I was at John A. Logan, it really gave me the mentality of we're coming in to teach the children, not to watch the children. And so it taught me the importance of engaging with them, becoming one with the classroom, and really having that involvement there.
Welcome to Mackey's. How can I help you?
Hey, welcome to Mackey's Pizza. Every Monday night we have half-price cheese breadsticks. Monday through Friday we have a great lunch special. We can get 8-inch pizza, a small salad, and a drink for $7.49. So come out and see us and enjoy everything at Mackey's.
John A. is the only auto collision program in Southern Illinois. There's nobody else that offers it. We draw students from all over because there's just nobody else that offers the programs. The student-teacher relationship is one of the most important parts of this job.
You can't really go wrong here. Anything you want to learn, you can learn it here.
Whenever I started the program, I didn't feel too 110% about it. Like, I wasn't sure how I was going to do, but that's what makes me confident. It's the teacher and the students that I'm surrounded by.
Hi guys, TJ Cowan from Cold Blooded. Coming to you, wanted to introduce the Cold Blooded Single Barrel Smokehouse. Here at John A. Logan College, you guys are used to our coffee, now come check out our food. Not your average college, not your average food.
Hey, welcome to Mackey's, how can I help you?
Hey, welcome to Mackey's Pizza. Every Monday night we have half-price cheese breadsticks. Monday through Friday we have a great lunch special. We can get 8-inch pizza, a small salad, and a drink for $7.49. So come out and see us and enjoy everything at Mackey's.
Our students are employed immediately. Sometimes they are employed before they get their associate's degree.
I have a position working in early childhood. Dr. Marilyn Tolliver, my professor, was able to really prepare me to be able to teach in a classroom as a lead teacher.
To see them interact and engage in what I'm teaching them is life-changing.
I'm the center director for Malone's Early Learning Center. You got to have that love and passion and being able to come here and see how rewarding it is to have a child learn how to tie their shoes or have a child learn how to stack blocks. It's so rewarding.
When I was at John A. Logan, it really gave me the mentality of we're coming in to teach the children, not to watch the children. And so it taught me the importance of engaging with them, becoming one with the classroom, and really having that involvement there.
Welcome to Mackey's. How can I help you?
Hey, welcome to Mackey's Pizza. Every Monday night we have half-price cheese breadsticks. Monday through Friday we have a great lunch special. We can get 8-inch pizza, a small salad, and a drink for $7.49. So come out and see us and enjoy everything at Mackey's.
John A. is the only auto collision program in Southern Illinois. There's nobody else that offers it. We draw students from all over because there's just nobody else that offers the programs. The student-teacher relationship is one of the most important parts of this job.
You can't really go wrong here. Anything you want to learn, you can learn it here.
Whenever I started the program, I didn't feel too 110% about it. Like, I wasn't sure how I was going to do, but that's what makes me confident. It's the teacher and the students that I'm surrounded by.
Hi guys, TJ Cowan from Cold Blooded. Coming to you, wanted to introduce the Cold Blooded Single Barrel Smokehouse. Here at Johnny Logan College, you guys are used to our coffee. Now come check out our food. Not your average college, not your average food.
Hey, welcome to Mackey's Pizza. Every Monday night we have half-price cheese breadsticks. Monday through Friday we have a great lunch special. We can get 8-inch pizza, a small salad, and a drink for $7.49. So come out and see us and enjoy everything at Mackey's.
Our students are employed immediately. Sometimes they are employed before they get their associate's degree.
I have a position working in early childhood. Dr. Marilyn Tolliver, my professor, was able to really prepare me to be able to teach in a classroom as a lead teacher.
To see them interact and engage in what I'm teaching them is life-changing.
I'm the center director for Malone's Early Learning Center. You got to have that love and passion and being able to come here and see how rewarding it is to have a child learn how to tie their shoes or have a child learn how to stack blocks. It's so rewarding.
When I was at John A. Logan, it really gave me the mentality of we're coming in to teach the children, not to watch the children. And so it taught me the importance of engaging with them, becoming one with the classroom, and really having that involvement there.
Welcome to Mackey's. How can I help you?
Hey, welcome to Mackey's Pizza. Every Monday night we have half-price cheese breadsticks. Monday through Friday we have a great lunch special. We can get 8-inch pizza, a small salad, and a drink for $7.49. So come out and see us and enjoy everything at Mackey's.
John A. is the only auto collision program in Southern Illinois. There's nobody else that offers it. We draw students from all over because there's just nobody else that offers the programs. The student-teacher relationship is one of the most important parts of this job.
You can't really go wrong here. Anything you want to learn, you can learn it here.
Whenever I started the program, I didn't feel too 110% about it. Like, I wasn't sure how I was going to do it, but that's what makes me confident. It's the teacher and the students that I'm surrounded by.
Hi guys, TJ Cowan from Cold Blooded. Coming to you, wanted to introduce the Cold Blooded Single Barrel Smokehouse. Here at Johnny Logan College, you guys are used to our coffee. Now come check out our food. Not your average college, not your average food.
Hey, welcome to Mackey's. How can I help you?
Hey, welcome to Mackey's Pizza. Every Monday night we have half-price cheese breadsticks. Monday through Friday we have a great lunch special. We can get 8-inch pizza, a small salad, and a drink for $7.49. So come out and see us and enjoy everything at Mackey's.
Our students are employed immediately. Sometimes they are employed before they get their associate's degree.
I have a position working in early childhood. Dr. Marilyn Tolliver, my professor, was able to really prepare me to be able to teach in a classroom as a lead teacher.
To see them interact and engage in what I'm teaching now is life-changing.
Nobody else has double digits. She's been pouring it on, and Logan's got to find a way to stop number two for the Lady Statesmen. Sarah Mills gets it into Poe in the backcourt, and she'll bring it on up across the timeline as we start the second half. Dasani Williams into the top of the key for Lincoln Trail. Passes over to Poe on the left wing. Hartman's defending, gets a pick from Williamson, back over to Williamson on the left wing now. She's going to try to go around Wolford Bird, goes baseline, sends up the reverse layup, but no good, and Wolford Bird has the rebound. She'll bring it up herself across court over to Hartman, back over to Wolford Bird, now to Cheyenne Trotter, baseline, back on out to Wolford Bird. Thought about the three, Poe came out to defend though. Here's Brown now, sends up the pull-up J, no good, Sprinkle gets the board. And here now comes Williamson with Hartman defending very closely over to Scroggins. Now into Poe's hand in the corner, driving baseline, stops, and now going to set up an open look, and no good, poked out. Brown has the rebound, and she's got to work against Sprinkle apparently. Brings it up across the timeline. Brown looks over to Hartman on the right side, drives in, goes past Sprinkle. Here's a right hand, it's good. Nice floater right there from Hartman. She's got 8 points now. Logan has made the first score in each quarter so far today. Sprinkle across the timeline. Calvin defending very closely. Getting double-teamed now by Calvin and Hartman. And driving in and ran right over to Calvin. There's going to be a whistle. Let's see. It's going to be on Sprinkle. They call a charge right there. Sprinkle's first. And Calvin's holding her head a little bit, but seems to be okay. I think it's just a crick in the neck. Hartman will inbound. 8:41 to go. Logan leads at 37-36. Into Brown. And technical call on Zach Wall right before halftime. He was given a warning and told to calm down and to, you know, stop with whatever he was saying. And apparently message was not received and came out of halftime. And 100 seconds in, 101 to be exact. It's 8:41 to go in the third. He says something, and the tee comes out. First one up for Tylee Wolford Bird is no good. She is scoreless in this game, looking for her first point. Here comes the second one, and it's good. She's into the scorebook finally. Every Lady Vol that's available today has scored. It will be Calvin inbounding on the far sideline. And first... need to have a conversation, I suppose, with the scorebook operator. And, yeah, still talking to the scorekeeper. And now we seem to be okay. Calvin will be inbounding, gets it on over to Brown. Brown gets it on over to Hartman on the right wing. Hartman looks on over to Calvin, top of the key to Brown. Drives baseline, sends up a pull-up J. It's good for Shamira. She's up to five on the day. 8:25 to go. Here is Poe across the timeline. Back on over to Scroggins, right wing. Back over to Sprinkle, top of the key. Sends up the three, and it's a little too strong. Went off the rim. Hartman gets the rebound, and here comes Liv across the timeline now to the left wing. And now it's over to Wolford Bird, top of the key. Wolford Bird inside to Trotter, out to Hartman. Corner three, and it's a little short. Rebounded by Sprinkle. And here comes Poe now with Wolford Bird to beat and sends up a pull-up jumper. No good. Sends up the left hand. Is good on the rebound. And Poe's up to 26 now. It's 39-39. Shamira Brown gets it on over to Kelvin. And she'll get it over to Hartman, who's past Poe. Goes inside. Floats it up. No good. And Williamson gets the rebound. 7:35 to go in the third quarter. Tie game here at Don Brewer Gymnasium, 39-39. Scroggins left wing over to Sprinkle. Corner three, and no good. Trotter gets the rebound. She'll bring it on up herself. And let's see, they're going to say she carried it. Yep, she sure did. Riley Johnson will come on in for Wolford Bird. 7:23 to go in the game. Rather, the third quarter, excuse me. And it will be Poe inbounding on the far sideline. Gets it into Scroggins in the backcourt. Scroggins brings it across the timeline. Jordan Scroggins goes to her left, near us, trying to, I think, create a little isolation. On over to Dasani Williamson. She's going to look to the right, and now backing on up again. Kind of clog things up again. Over to Scroggins once again on the far side. 7 minutes to go, 8 on the shot clock. Scroggins on over to Sprinkle in the corner. Sprinkle looking around, 3 on the shot clock. Poked out, Kelvin digs it away, and she's got no one in front of her. Sends up the left hand, and it's good for Kelvin. She's up to 8 on the day. 6:45 to go in the third quarter. Logan leads 41-39 here at Don Burge Gymnasium. Sprinkle brings it across the timeline. Bounced down to Mills, who tries to save it. Goes out of bounds, though. It should be Logan Ball here, and some Logan players actually affected that a bunch. Almost looked like it was going to be a steal. A.J. Johnson comes in for Sprinkle, and it will be Calvin inbounding to Liv Hartman. Liv will walk it on up with Calvin to her right. 6.5 to go in the third. Logan leads 41-39 in this play-in game. Winner gets Wabash Valley Sunday at 1 o'clock. Here is Riley Johnson for a deep two from the right wing. No good. Trotter got the rebound, sent it up. It goes down, and she'll go to the line to shoot the and one. 7 points for Trotter here today, looking to make it 8. Scroggins picks up her second foul of the day, second team foul as well for Lincoln Trail here in the third quarter. Trotter not the best free throw shooter. She is 1-for-4 here today. First one, the and one goes up, no good. And is rebounded by Williamson. Over to Scroggins. Jordan Scroggins will bring it on up across the timeline. Over to Johnson, driving in into the paint. Sends it back up with the right hand. Is good. Johnson with 4 points now. 6 minutes to go in the third. Logan leads 43-41. Alaysia Devine, rather, coming back into this game at the next stoppage. Here now is Calvin over to Brown right wing, driving over to the baseline to Johnson. Riley Johnson into Trotter. Turn around, and they're calling a jump ball. And she got tied up with, I think it was Williamson. Devine comes in for Williamson. Logan keeps possession, and Shamira Brown goes to the baseline to inbound here. 13 on the shot clock, 5:46 on the game clock in the third quarter. Brown looks around, lobs it on in, and got it to Trotter. Back over to Brown, baseline. Jay is good. Brown's got 7-4 in this quarter. Devine bringing it up on over to Johnson. Breaks through the defense. Over to Scroggins. Left wing three from her. And it bounces off the back iron. No good. Trotter comes down with the rebound. Cheyenne comes across the timeline. On over to Calvin. And stop. And, oh, got it back out to Cheyenne. Over to Riley. And here's a whistle. I think it's going to be a reach foul here. And it will be on Sarah Mills. Her first, the third team foul for Lincoln Trail. 5:19 to go in the third quarter. Logan leads it 45-41. 21 on the shot clock. Brown goes to the baseline, lobs into Trotter, and Poe. They're saying a push foul on Trotter. Poe affected it enough, but they say Trotter picks up her third foul, the first team foul for Logan in the third. Kendra Johnson coming into the game. Trotter's going to take a seat with her three fouls. Can't falter. She's trying, without a doubt. Into Scroggins, on over to Johnson. Across the timeline she goes. And Trenisha Johnson gets it over to Devine on the left wing. Goes to the right, working against Riley Johnson. To Mills, back over to Devine. Devine stopped, over to Scroggins, top of the key three. Bounces off, no good. Poked out, and Devine's working for it. Goes out of bounds, and it will be Lincoln Trail ball. Calvin, I think, touched it last. Johnson on the baseline. Looks to get it into her team. Bounce down low, but Kendra Johnson's there. On over to Calvin. Give Johnson the steal. Over to Hartman. Send it up. Oh, no good, but there's a foul. And whom is it on? This should send Liv to the line. It's on Gracie Poe. Fourth team foul for Lincoln Trail. 4:55 to go in the third quarter. Logan leads at 45-41. Liv Hartman goes to the line when we come back in a minute on 103.5 ESPN.com.
My name's Lee Eklund. I'm the center director for Malone's Early Learning Center. You got to have that love and passion and being able to come here and see how rewarding it is to have a child learn how to tie their shoes or have a child learn how to stack blocks. It's so rewarding.
When I was at John A. Logan, it really gave me the mentality of we're coming in to teach the children, not to watch the children. And so it taught me the importance of engaging with them, becoming one with the classroom, and really having that involvement there.
Hey, welcome to Mackey's. How can I help you?
Hey, welcome to Mackey's Pizza. Every Monday night we have half-price cheese breadsticks. Monday through Friday we have a great lunch special. We can get 8-inch pizza, a small salad, and a drink for $7.49. So come out and see us and enjoy everything at Mackey's.
45-41 in the third quarter. Logan leads it here against Lincoln Trail in the play-in game. Winner gets Wabash Valley Sunday at 1 o'clock. 4:55 to go in the third. If Logan wins this one, we'll have that game right here on 103.5 ESPN.com up at Lakeland. First one up for Liv Hartman is no good. She's 0 for 2 on the day. On the season, she shoots just 69.8%. Second one up and no good for Hartman. And it's rebounded by Trail. And Scroggins gets it on over to Devine. Pull-up jumper, no good, and it is rebounded by Hartman. Here comes Liv across the timeline, over to Brown on the left wing. Sends up a corner three, and no good. Rebounded by Calvin, sends it back up, and that one goes in. And finally, a Lady Vol has double digits. Calvin, the first 1-10. Gracie Poe leads everybody with 26. Here's Poe now on the other end, left wing. Back on over to Johnson, top of the key. 47-41 lead for Logan, 4:15 to go in the third. Here's Devine on the far side, working against Kendra Johnson, driving in, sends it up, no good. Riley Johnson got the rebound. On over to Calvin. Madison across the timeline, top of the key, driving in. And they're going to whistle. And Riley Johnson picks up a foul away from the ball. Might have been an illegal screen. It's tough to tell exactly what it was. Scroggins gets the inbound over to Johnson. Lives defending. Lobs it into Poe. Poked out by one of the Lady Vols. And Poe will be inbounding into the front court. 3:55 to go in the third. Poe looks around. Gets it into Mills. Mills on over to Antonisha Johnson. Johnson on over to the left wing. Scroggins has it, driving in against Brown. There's a whistle before she gets a shot up. And it will be on Brown. They're calling a block on her, I think. And it'll be her second foul, 13th foul for Logan. And Trail inbounds to Scroggins, on over to Poe. Left wing goes around Hartman. Back out to Scroggins, uncorked from the corner. And it's no good, poked out by Calvin. But Devine, the one that looks like she, oh, it's on the ground. And Trail, it's Johnson and Calvin and Kendra Johnson all getting tied up. 3:35 to go, jump ball, and it'll be Trail ball. 17 on the shot clock as Poe will be inbounding on the far sideline. And Gracie gets it on in to A.J. Johnson. Top of the key for A.J. Over to Devine, left wing, down low to Poe, working against Hartman. Back on out to Mills, on over to Johnson. Six on the shot clock. Johnson gets a pick from Mills, goes to the left away from it to Poe, left wing three, and it's in the air, no good. Air ball by Poe, but that was a desperation shot, goes out of bounds, and it'll be Logan Ball, 3:18 to go after the shot clock violation. Brown will bring it on up across the timeline with Calvin to her right. Brown out to Calvin, top of the key, into Kendrick Johnson, sends it up, and no good in the paint. Rebounded by Scroggins. Getting trapped by Johnson and Brown out to Poe. And this is going to be a foul on Kendra Johnson, her first, fourth team foul for Logan here in the quarter. Looked like they were going to the bonus before the media break, and then all of a sudden they've rallied off a bunch of fouls here. Chloe Sprinkle comes on in for Elijah Davis, or Devine, excuse me. 3:01 to go. And Coach Amanda Shelby is just as confused as I am about that call. It was way away from the ball. Who called it and everything? Just tough to see. Johnson across the timeline, left wing going inside, gets double teamed by Riley and Maddie, and looks to get it on over to the other side to Poe, but missed her and goes into the stands. 2:51 to go in the third quarter. Logan leads at 47-41. Tally Wolford Bird comes back into the game. Jamira Brown's going to take a seat. Hartman on the far sideline. Gets it into Calvin in the backcourt. And she'll cross the timeline. 2:45 to go. Here is Hartman. Gets it into the corner to Riley. Back on over to Hartman. Kendra saves it. And spinning around, there's a foul. And it's on, I believe, Sarah Mills, her second. A reach called. 2:40 to go in the third. This game has become pretty sloppy here in the third quarter. Kendra Johnson goes to the line as that was the fifth team foul for Trail. Johnson on the day is 4-for-4, made them all in the first quarter. Looking for her first points in the second half. Sends it up and it's good. 5-for-5 on the day. She's got 8 points. Kendra probably going to be up at the 80% mark by the end of this one. Second one up and good. She's 6-for-6. She's got 9 points on the day. Here is Sprinkle. Gets it on over to Scroggins. And splits two defenders. On over to Poe on the right wing. Sends up the three uncorked. And just a little short. Poked on out. And Calvin has the board. Into Riley. And she's going to get it on over to Tiley. Swings it on over to Hartman across the way. Gets it into the paint. Turnaround jumper. Rolls off no good. It's rebounded by Kendra, send it up and in. She's now leading the Vols with 11 points. Here's Poe across the timeline, driving in. Bounce on over to Mills, left hand no good, but she got fouled and will go to the line to shoot two. 2:09 to go in the third quarter. Foul is on Calvin, her third of the game. Logan was tied up 39-39 earlier in the quarter, and they have since gone on a 12-2 run. Brown comes back in for Calvin. 2:09 to go in the third. It's 51-41. Mills at the stripe sends the first one up. And off the back iron, no good. She's got 2 points on the day. On the season, Mills averages 65% at the stripe. Here comes the second one from Sarah Mills, up and off the back iron, no good. Rebounded by Scroggins, though. Over to Poe, driving in, out to the left wing for a three from Sprinkle, and it's too strong. Brown gets the rebound. Shamira being trapped by Scroggins, and Mills gets it on out to Wolford Bird, a whistle. And I think this is going to be on, yes, that'll be on Scroggins, her third of the game, sends Shamira to the stripe. With 1:57 to go in the third. Winner of this game gets Wabash Valley on Sunday, number 12 in the nation. Will not be an easy task for either Logan or Lincoln Trail. Brown on the season as she goes to the line, shooting 76.9%. First one up and good for Shamira. She has eight. looking for nine here now. Up and bounces around, no good. Rebounded by Monier Allen, who just came back into the game. And a whistle as we're going up court is on Shamira Brown, her third. So Logan's now got to be careful. They got three of their eligible seven players with three fouls with about 12 minutes left in this game. 52-41 the lead for Logan as A.J. Johnson goes to the stripe on the season. She averages 58.5 at the line. She's got four on the day so far. Bounces the ball, spins the ball, sends it up, and off the back iron, no good. Here comes the second one. Bounces it a few times, looks up, spins it, and sends it up, and it is good. So she's got five on the day. Here is Hartman across the timeline. Over to Wofford Bird. Wofford Bird inside to Kendra Johnson. Turns around, jumper. It's good from the paint. She's got 13 today. Here's Poe on over to Sprinkle across the timeline to the left wing. Back over to Poe. 90 seconds in the quarter. Poe top of the key. Goes to the left over to Sprinkle on the wing. Back over to Williamson at the top of the key. Inside to Allen. Turnaround jumper. No good. She got fouled by Kendra Johnson, though. Quick on the whistle, at least. And so that's going to send Monier Allen to the line after Kendra Johnson picks up her second of the day. Allen on the season, averaging 100% of the stripe. I don't think she goes too often, though. Here comes the first one from Monier Allen. Up and no good. So there goes that 100% for her. Logan leads at 54-42. Here comes the second from Allen. And it's good. Makes it 54-43 as Allen enters the scorebook. Brown brings it across the timeline. On over to Riley Johnson. Back over to Kendra Johnson. Now it's Wofford Bird on the far side. Gets it on over to Brown at the top of the key. Back over to Kendra on the right wing. 15 on the shot clock. Minute 4 on the game clock. Wofford Bird back on over to Kendra now on the right wing. Lobs into Riley, send it up. Oh, couldn't get it. And it's rebounded by Poe over to Williamson. Back on over to Poe. She'll bring it on up. 45 seconds to go in the quarter. Poe top of the key, goes to the left, driving into the paint. Flips it up, got blocked by Riley Johnson. And here now comes Brown. Across the timeline she goes. On over to Kendra on the right wing. Sends up the three. Oh, just a little off. Riley gets the rebound. Up, no good, but she'll go to the stripe. 31.6 in the third quarter. Foul is on Chloe Sprinkle, her second of the day. Riley's got eight on the day. On the season, when she goes to the line, she shoots 51%. First one up, and it's good. 9 points for her. All the Lady Vols starting to get near double digits now. Second one up, and it's good. She's got 10. Three Lady Vols have entered double digits in this quarter alone. Kendra Johnson, Riley Johnson, and Madison Calvin. Sprinkle across the timeline. And they can just let this be their last possession if they want. Johnson drives baseline, floats it up. It's good. She's been finding the touch in this quarter with Gracie Poe going eyes cold. Hartman across the timeline, drives in, into the corner. Back on over to Kendra, drives it in, flips it up. It's good for Kendra. She's on fire this quarter. And here's a desperation shot at the quarter. No good. Logan leads it. Headed into the final frame, 58-45. Logan looking like they might be headed to Lakeland College on Sunday. We're back in a minute on 103.5 ESPN. Doug.
John A. is the only auto collision program in Southern Illinois. There's nobody else that offers it. We draw students from all over because there's just nobody else that offers the programs. The student-teacher relationship is one of the most important parts of this job.
You can't really go wrong here. Anything you want to learn, you can learn it here.
Whenever I started the program, I didn't feel too 110% about it. Like, I wasn't sure how I was going to do, but that's what makes me confident. It's the teacher and the students that I'm surrounded by.
Hi guys, TJ Cowan from Cold Blooded. Coming to you, wanted to introduce the Cold Blooded Single Barrel Smokehouse. Here at Johnny Logan College, you guys are used to our coffee. Now come check out our food. Not your average college, not your average food.
Fourth quarter beginning here at Logan, 58-45, the lead for the Lady Vols. Just need to maintain that, and they are in the region tournament playing Wabash Valley Sunday at 1 o'clock. That was a 9-point quarter for Lincoln Trail. They completely cooled off Gracie Poe, who had 24 at the half. She's got 26 now after that third quarter. Calvin has it, and oh, Shemira Brown not able to hold on to it. Rolls right out of bounds right in front of us. 23-point third quarter for Logan. Madison Calvin has 10, Kendra Johnson has 15, and Riley Johnson has 10. Those are your main scorers here today. Chloe Sprinkle, top of the key, flips on over to Poe, top of the key now. Being defended by Calvin. Over to A.J. Johnson, right wing. Wolford Bird defending. Into Scroggins, flips it up with the left hand, and it's good. She gets the roll. She's up to 10. Second Lincoln Trail player up to double digits. Here's Brown on over to Calvin on the left wing to Wolford Bird on the wing. Looking around, gets it inside to Calvin, on over to Riley. Back out to Wolford Bird, top of the key. They didn't like what they saw. Back on over to Riley in the corner, driving baseline now, floats it up. That one too strong, rebounded by Poe. 9 minutes to go in the game. Here is Poe on the left wing, brings it back out. And Scroggins had it. Calvin almost stole it away. Back out to Poe in the corner. Thought about the three. They're calling a travel on Poe. She can't believe it. Her coach, Zach Lowe, can't believe it, but he knows he can't really say anything because he already got hit with one tee. 8:54 to go. Calvin, in front of the Lincoln Trail bench, gets it on over to Brown across the timeline. Lobs into Johnson on the right wing. Back down low to Riley. Johnson sends it up. No foul called, even though she got hit with the body. Rebounded by Scroggins. On over to Johnson on the far side. Sends up a pull-up jumper, and it rattles down. She's got 9 on the day. Here's Kendra, top of the key, going in. Bounce on over to Wolford Bird. Right wing 3 from her, and she flushes it down. Wow. Haven't seen that from her all day. You've been waiting for it, and finally she makes it. 61-49, the lead for Logan, and a carry called here on Trail as they bring it up. 8:16 to go. Logan leads it by 12. And it will be Calvin inbounding on the far sideline. Into Brown. Across the timeline she goes. Brown top of the key. Over to Wolford Bird on the right wing. Down low to Riley Johnson, who was not ready for it. And goes out of bounds. 8:08 in the game, 61-49. Logan leads it. Here's Sprinkle across the timeline. Over to Poe on the right wing. Poe looking around, gets a pick from Sprinkle. Over to Scroggins, top of the key. Now Johnson, left wing, driving in. Sends up the right hand. It's no good. She'll go to the line after Wolford Bird affected the shot enough and got the foul. Tylee picks up her second foul of the game. And Johnson will be shooting 2 now. Johnson was 1-for-2 earlier in the game at the stripe. Johnson spins it, sends it up, and rolls off no good. Went in and then rolled out. 7:53 to go in the game. Logan leads at 61-49. Johnson's 1-for-3 at the stripe here today. Second one goes up, and it is good. So she's 2-for-4 at the stripe now. She's got 10 points. Here is Calvin over to Kendra across the timeline. Into Wolford Bird on the right wing. And now she stops looking, gets it across court to Brown on the left wing. She brings it around back over to Tiley, uncorked from the right wing, and it's off the iron, no good. Riley got the rebound, got it back out to Tiley at the top of the key. Tiley over to Shamira on the left wing. Inside to Kendra, drives in, flips it up with the right hand, no good. She got fouled and will go to the line. Kendra with 15 on the day. Malaysia Devine picks up her fourth foul of the day. She's been a complete non-factor because every time that she gets into the game, she fouls. First one up and in for Kendra. Makes it 62-50. Here's the second one, and it is good. 17 points for Kendra here. Sarah Mills comes on in, and Devine takes a seat. 7:27 to go. 63-50, the lead for Logan. Scroggins was the intended pass recipient. Kendra Johnson leaps up into the air, pokes it, and it goes out of bounds. Scroggins will inbound, gets it into Johnson across the timeline. Top of the key, looks to the left, to the right, back to the left, back to the right, gets it to Sprinkle on the far side. Gets a pick from Mills, goes to the left, away from it. Now it's Poe top of the key. Poe goes to the right after a pick from Sprinkle into the hands of Scroggins. Drives, pull-up jumper. It's no good, and it's rebounded by Johnson. Johnson brings it back out to Poe. Two on the shot clock, sends up the desperation shot. No good off the rim, and Brown gets the rebound. Shamira brings it on up, gets it on over to Riley. Oh, Poe steals it away on the other end. Here comes Gracie Poe now. Scroggins in the corner, uncorked for the three, and that one bounces off no good. A whistle. And they're going to say it's Logan Ball. Don't know what it was exactly, but we'll find out who. And it is on Sarah Mills, so it must have been a push foul there. 6:43 to go now in the game. Logan leads at 63-50. They maintain this lead. They will play Wabash Valley Sunday at 1 o'clock at Lakeland College in the Region 24 tournament. Who Coach Amanda Shelby called the Dragon. And you're going to want to try and slay the Dragon. Gracie Poe almost stole it away again, but Calvin able to retrieve it. Here's a floater in the lane. No good. Gets her own rebound. Up and in it goes for Madison. She's got 12 on the day. 65-50. Here is Scroggins on the near side, trying to bring it on up. Working against Brown. Across the timeline she goes to A.J. Johnson on the far side. Johnson, top of the key to Sprinkle. Sprinkle with a pick. Gets it to Mills, down low to Poe, and back out to Scroggins for a deep two, and no good, rebounded by Johnson. 6 minutes to go, Logan leads by 15. Here's Warford Bird on the left wing, sends up the three, and she flushes it down. 7 points for Tylee. She was ice cold in the first half, had 1 point in the third, and all of a sudden she's come to life here in the final frame. And Chloe Sprinkle had the ball. Riley Johnson poked it out, goes out of bounds. I think she thought Sprinkle might have touched it last because she made sure she didn't touch it, but that was that. Calvin comes off as Trotter comes in. Hartman comes in also as Brown takes a seat. 5:40 to go. Sprinkle gets the inbound at the volleyball line, being defended by Trotter. That's a mismatch. Sprinkle drives, gets it on over to Poe in the corner. And she's going to bring it around. Curls in, flips it up with the left hand. It's good. She is up to 28 points on the day. Timeout called by Zach Law. 5:26 to go in the game. Logan leads it 68-52. We're back in a minute.
Welcome to Mackey's. How can I help you?
Hey, welcome to Mackey's Pizza. Every Monday night we have half-price cheese breadsticks. Monday through Friday, we have a great lunch special. We can get 8-inch pizza, a small salad, and a drink for $7.49. So come out and see us and enjoy everything at Mackey's.
Our students are employed immediately. Sometimes they are employed before they get their associate's degree.
I have a position working in early childhood. Dr. Marilyn Tolliver, my professor, was able to really prepare me to be able to teach in a classroom as a lead teacher.
To see them interact and engage in what I'm teaching them It's life-changing.
...68-52, 5:26 to go in the game. Logan leads Lincoln Trail in the play-in game for the Region 24 tournament. Kendra Johnson had a huge third quarter with 8 points. Got her to 15. She's made a pair of free throws since, and she has 17 leading the Vols. Gracie Poe leads everybody with 28, but she's only had 4 in this half so far. 5:26 to go. Logan maintains this now 16-point lead. They're going to Lakeland College on Sunday at 1 o'clock. Liv Hartman on the baseline, looking to inbound. Looking around, gets it in to Kendra. Oh, stolen away by A.J. Johnson. Now it's Sprinkle, top of the key. On over to Poe on the left wing. Sends up the three, and it's no good. Rebounded by Hartman. And poked out by Scroggins. Goes out of bounds, and it'll be Logan Ball still. 5:14 to go. Kendra Johnson will inbound on the far sideline, and now Trail is showing pressure into Trotter in the front court. Back over to Wolford Bird on the near side. Tylee looks around, steps to her left now, and now gets it over to Kendra on the left wing. Kendra steps to the right, gets it inside to Riley, and was looking for a pass, but Sarah Mills affected it enough, and Scroggins steals it away. Jordan Scroggins on the near side, gets it on over to her teammate Gracie Poe, who'll race across the timeline now. Poe drives into the lane, flips it up with the left hand, and it's good. She is up to 30 points on the day. 4:40 to go. Here is Trotter with it across the timeline to Riley, sends it up. It's good for Riley Johnson. She's got 12 on the day. Give the assist to Cheyenne Trotter. Johnson across the timeline now. On the left wing, and going to drive in, get it on out to Scroggins for a corner two. No good, and Hartman has the rebound. 4:15 to go in the game. Logan leads it 70-54. Here is Wolford Bird on the far side across the timeline. Gets it on over to Kendra, top of the key, being defended by Poe. Johnson into Riley Johnson, looking to pass, going to drive though, back over to Kendra, baseline jumper, and rolls around, no good. Sarah Mills gets the rebound. Here now comes A.J. Johnson, top of the key, driving in, she evaded Riley Johnson, flips it up, no good, poked out by Hartman, and she tracks down the rebound, and now Riley Johnson down near the baseline, slow to get up. 3:45 to go in the game. Logan leads 70-54. The trainer's coming on out. We'll step away for a minute. Be back on 135ESPN.com.
I got Bassett.
But did have a bit of a limp, hoping that she is all right. She's getting checked out by the trainer right now. Lob into Liv Hartman as we restart play. Across the timeline she goes. Being defended by Poe. Flip on over to Madison Calvin. At the volleyball line is where she stands. Goes to the left, gets it on over to Johnson on the left wing. Kendra on over to Wolford Bird on the right wing. And now she's going to step to the left. Bounce down low to Cheyenne Trotter. Up and in with the right hand. 9 points for Cheyenne with 3:15 to go in the game. It's 72-54. Chloe Sprinkle will bring it on up for Trail. Gets it on over to Johnson. Across the timeline. 3 minutes to go now. Johnson, top of the key, stops. Gets it over to Scroggins on the far side. And now inside to Johnson on the baseline, working against Calvin on the reverse layup. No good. It was short. And Calvin has the rebound. Across the timeline she goes. Maddie on over to Wolford Bird on the far side. 2:45 to go now in the game. Logan leads at 72-54. Give it on over to Hartman. And ran into Johnson. I think that's going to be a block on Johnson. We'll find out here in just a moment. Yes, it will be her first foul of the game. 2:41 to go. Third team foul for Trail. Calvin will inbound on the far sideline in front of some fans. Johnson's defending, jumping all around. Calvin's got to find somebody. Gets it into Trotter on the left wing, and she'll get it over to Wolford Bird on the near side. 15 on the shot clock, and she's going to lob over to Calvin at the top of the key. Get it over to Hartman on the right wing. Hartman goes to the right, and they're calling the travel after getting a pick from Wolford Bird. 2:25 to go. Poe will inbound in front of the Logan bench. Gets it on over to Sprinkle, over to Johnson. Johnson across the timeline now. Top of the key, gets it over to Poe on the left wing, gets a pick from Mills, goes to the right, goes to the left, runs into Hartman, down low, turn around, and she got fouled by Hartman, and go to the line to shoot two. Liv Hartman's first foul of the game, comes at the 2:10 mark in the fourth. And it will send Poe to the stripe. She is 5-5 at the stripe today, hasn't shot one in the second half. On the season, she came into the game shooting 78%. I imagine that's up at 80 at this point. First one up and good for Poe. Makes her 6-for-6 on the day. Looking to go 7-for-7 with this one. Up and good. She's got 32 points on the day. It's 72-56. Trotter across the timeline for Logan. Gets it on over to Wolford Bird. She's getting trapped now and goes out of bounds. Stays with Logan. They say that Scroggins or perhaps Sarah Mills touched it last. Calvin will inbound right in front of us. 2:01 to go in the game. Calvin looks. Scroggins defending. And gets it into Wolford Bird on the right wing. 2 minutes to go. Over to Johnson at the volleyball line. Speaking of Johnson, Riley's back on the bench. Top of the key, over to Kendra Johnson. Left wing three from her, and she nails it. 20 points for Kendra Johnson. Here now is A.J. Johnson, top of the key. Minute 40 to go in the game. Inside to Scroggins, sends it up. It's good. She got fouled. She go to the line. 12 points for Scroggins. Minute 37 to go. 75-58 is the score here at Logan. Kendra Johnson picks up her third foul of the game. Third team foul for Logan as well. Four Lady Vols have three team fouls in this one. Scroggins sends the and one up. It's good. She's got 13. Here comes Kendra now with 90 seconds to go in the game. Liv has it. Got pushed in the air. Came down fine. And now driving, sends it over to Calvin on the other side, sends it up, oh, no good. Rebounded by Trotter, though, up, no good, got fouled, will go to the stripe. 1:20 to go in the game, Logan leads at 75-59. At this point, I think it's a foregone conclusion. Logan will be headed to Lakeland College to face number 12 in the nation, Wabash Valley, on Sunday at 1 o'clock. Trotter goes to the stripe. She's made 1 out of 5 today. First one up. And rolls off no good. Got closer, though, than she normally does. You can tell she's been working on it. She's getting a lot closer to the rim. Earlier in the season, she was doing a lot of air balls. Here comes the second one from the Springfield native. Sends it up, and it's good. She's 2-for-7 at the stripe today. 76-59, the lead for Logan. Minute 10 to go in the game. A.J. Johnson top of the key. Drives left into the paint. Flips it up on the floater. It's good, and she'll go to the line for the and one. Johnson has 12, looking for 13. Calvin's got her first foul of the day, fourth foul, rather, of the day. Minute 7 left on the clock. 75-61 the lead for Logan. And here now is A.J. Johnson for the and one. Sends it up, and it bounces off, no good. Hartman gets the rebound. Johnson's got 12. Kendra gets it over to Hartman. Across the timeline, she'll walk. A minute to go in the game now. Hartman on the far side gets it over to Calvin. She's going to race inside. Gets it out. Was looking for Hartman, but instead got poked out, and Gracie Poe takes it away. There comes Poe. Steps to the left wing, and Trotter defending. Poe goes inside, sends it up, and she got fouled, I think, by Wolford Bird. Trotter was doing a good job, but lost her. And Wolford Bird came across to defend. 13 foul, or rather a personal foul for her, as Poe goes to the stripe. She's 7 for 7 at the line today. Sends it up. It's good. She's got 33. 43.7 on the clock. Here comes the second one. It's also good. So put her down for 34. That might be where her day ends. 76-63. Kendra Johnson across the timeline. 37 seconds to go and a foul by A.J. Johnson, her second of the day. Sends Kendra Johnson to the line. She's 8 for 8 at the stripe. Both teams in the bonus. Kendra will go to the line to shoot 9 and 10. First one up is good. She has 21. 77-63 the score. 35 seconds to go in the game. Second one up, also good. She is 10 for 10 at the line. 22 points on the day for Kendra Johnson. A.J. Johnson across the timeline, racing into the paint, flips it on up, and no good. It's rebounded by her teammate, and Madison Calvin came across and fouled. That's going to be a foul out for Maddie. Her fifth. Riley Johnson comes back on in. And Mills will go to the stripe. She's 0 for 2 so far today. All smiles for Calvin and the coaching staff. First one up for Mills is good. Makes her 1 for 3 at the stripe. She's got 3 points today as well. 28.1, 78-64 the score here at Logan. Here comes the second one from her. Up and no good. Kendra Johnson gets the rebound. Scroggins was defending. And now getting trapped. And someone's got to help her and gets it over to Wolford Bird across the timeline. Now it's Hartman with it, and they can just run the clock out at this point. 12 seconds to go, and Lincoln Trail's trying to trap still. Kendra Johnson with it, 8 seconds to go, and yeah, they'll just pass it around. That's going to be it. Logan wins at 78-64. They are headed to Lakeland College on Sunday, 1 o'clock tip-off against number 12 Wabash Valley, and they'll try to slay the dragon, as Coach Amanda Shelby says. We'll be back in a minute with Coach Amanda Shelby on the postgame show on 103.5 ESPN.
My name is Lee Eklund. I'm the center director for Malone's Early Learning Center. You got to have that love and passion and being able to come here and see how rewarding it is to have a child learn how to tie their shoes or have a child learn how to stack blocks. It's so rewarding.
When I was at John A. Logan, it really gave me the mentality of we're coming in to teach the children, not to watch the children. And so it taught me the importance of engaging with them, becoming one with the classroom, and really having that involvement there.
Welcome to Mackey's. How can I help you?
Hey, welcome to Mackey's Pizza. Every Monday night we have half-price cheese breadsticks. Monday through Friday we have a great lunch special. We can get 8-inch pizza, a small salad, and a drink for $7.49. So come out and see us and enjoy everything at Mackey's.
John A.
I advised the other student.
Oh, yeah?
Well, I told her.
Welcome back to John A. Logan Women's Basketball. Matt Varney on the postgame show after a 78-64 win for the Lady Vols, marking down their ninth win of the season. They punched their ticket to the Region 24 tournament officially. Coach Amanda Shelby joins us now on the postgame show. And, you know, it had its moments there, Coach, but you pick up the win. That's what matters.
It did have its moments. Good moments, bad moments. So, yeah. You know, it is what it is at the end. You know, this is the win or go home type of game, and thankfully we came out on the winning end.
Yeah, and I mean, Gracie Poe was fantastic for them. In the first half, she had 24 points. You limited her to just 10 in the second and 2 in the third quarter. I imagine at halftime, that was the big conversation. It was, she's the one that's beating you. You just have to go out and stop her, and you did that job.
Yeah, thankfully we did. Yeah, 2 and 11 were their best players, and we definitely had to shut them down. And Poe was a great player, and like you said, we limited her to 2 points in the third quarter. That definitely did help in the win.
Kendra Johnson comes off the bench to give you 22 points. And, I mean, she's one of those players that clearly, you know, coming off the bench is her strong suit. Doesn't matter at all. You've seen it at every level of the sport. Just, you know, some people see things differently coming off the bench, and she's really grown into the role this year and kind of turned into a little bit of a star in that way, just not in the starting five.
Yeah, no, I mean, she does great. Even if she was in the starting five, you know, she just comes in and does a great job. She can shoot the three. She's very smart when it comes to basketball. She's got a great IQ. She finds the ball. She finds the hole where she needs to be. And, you know, and it's a silent 22, silent 19. You don't know until you look at the scorebook. You're like, oh, wow, she did this. So, yeah, she does a great job.
Also made 10 shots at the free throw line. 10 for 10 at the line. I mean, that's always nice for a player. I'm sure you're happy to hear that just for your team to make 10, because I know the past, since I've been doing this, I know there's been a lot of struggles at the line, and so to hear just one player even made 10 shots is fantastic for you.
Yes, our free throw shooting can be interesting at times. So, but yeah, anytime anybody can shoot 10 for 10, that definitely does help. And in a close game like this, you know, that does win the ball game.
Yeah, absolutely. You go to Lakeland College on Sunday, 1 o'clock tip, against number 12 in the nation, Wabash Valley. When we talked on the pregame, you know, you said it, I think, the best. You go, you try to slay the dragon. You know, that's truly what they are. They're a dragon, and you're just kind of a knight trying to go out there and defend your province, if you will. And it won't be easy, you know that. But, I mean, honestly, from what I remember about them, they're going to have 5 Gracie Poes out there all at the same time, really.
That's true. You know, I mean, and the pressure's off of us now. You know, the pressure's on them to win the whole tournament, to go out to the national tournament to win. And, you know, maybe we'll catch them on a night where they're not hitting well, or we catch them on the night that they already say, hey, we've already won the tournament. We don't even bother to do any of this. You know, so, I mean, anything can happen. We can go and do a great job. So, you know, hey, we just got up there, lay it all out on the line, play as hard as we can, see what happens after 4 quarters.
Thanks a lot, Coach. Congratulations, 78-64, and we'll see you on Sunday, hopefully celebrating a win.
Yeah, no kidding. Thank you so much.
That's Coach Amanda Shelby of the Lady Vols after a 78-64 win over Lincoln Trail to advance on into the official Region 24 tournament on Sunday. 1 o'clock tip against number 12, Wabash Valley. Quickly going over the scores for today. Kendra Johnson led the Lady Vols with 22 points. Madison Calvin had 12, so did Riley Johnson. Cheyenne Trotter had 10. Olivia Hartman and Shamira Brown had 8. And Tylee Wofford Bird finished the day with 7, 6 of which came in the fourth quarter. For Lincoln Trail, they were led by Gracie Poe, who had 34 points. Next, it was Jordan Scroggins with 13. Antronisha Johnson had 12. And Sarah Mills had 3. And we have the water jug being poured all over the court trying to get Matt Crane. They're just happy to be able to keep it this season alive. Sarah Mills finishes the day with 3, and Dasani Williamson finishes the day with just a point. Logan wins it over Lincoln Trail, 78-64. The men play Monday at 1 o'clock against either Lewis and Clark or Shawnee at Rend Lake. Go ahead and support them. We'll have that on 103.5 ESPN. The women play number 12 Wabash Sunday at 1 o'clock at Lakeland College. We'll have it right here on 103.5 ESPN.com. I want to say thanks to Rick Hayes back in the studio, helping to bring this game to you. We could not do what we do without Rick, and making sure that he puts out the fires that he finds throughout the broadcast. He tries to make it as smooth and seamless as possible, and most of the time you don't even know that something is up. So thank you to Rick, and thanks for all he does. For Rick Hayes, back in the studio, I am Matt Varney, and we will see you Sunday when...